Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, we'll be working on button cooldowns. So let's generate a button. So let's click the button. And it says hi, let's click it again. And now you've been rate limited. And it says try again in 57.4 seconds. Okay, now let's go to our code. Okay, so we're gonna be building off of our discordpy/commands framework from our discordpy/commands video. If you want more information about this code, I'd recommend you watch the video linked up here in the top right card. And let's import commands now. Okay, so we're going to be using commands for our cooldown later. Okay, now let's create our view that will hold our button. Okay, so this is our view that will hold our button view. We're going to create a variable that holds our cooldown mapping. Okay, so this is our cooldown mapping. We set the cooldown to one button click per every 60 seconds per member. So there are a variety of different bucket types you can use, but we're going to be using member. So for bucket types, you can have default, which is like a global basis, cooldown, user, guild, channel, member, category, and role cooldown. Okay, now let's create our button. Okay, so this is our button. I'm going to call it hello. Its style is going to be purple, and its custom ID is going to be button with cooldown. And then we have self, which is our view, and then our interaction and button. Okay, now let's work on the cooldown part. We're going to want to set the interactions messages author to the user, because typically the interactions messages author, interaction.message.author, would be the bot, since the bot sent the message. So we don't want that, because otherwise the cooldown would be sort of a global cooldown instead of a member by member cooldown. So we want to set the messages author to the user. And then we want to get the bucket from our cooldown. And then we'll want to update it and see if there is a cooldown. This will make a bit more sense after I write the code. Okay, so we set interaction.message.author to the user because we want the code to interpret the message as being sent by the user rather than being sent by the bot. This way it can apply the cooldown. After that, we get our bucket and then we pass our message. And then we update our bucket, and then we see if retry after is anything. If it's nothing, which is none, that means there is no cooldown. But if it returns a float, that means that there is a cooldown. And then we can respond to the user saying, you are on cooldown, try again in XYZ seconds. Okay, so we check and see if retry is anything. If it is, we're going to respond saying slow down and try again in retry seconds rounded to one decimal place, and then it'll be an ephemeral message. If retry is none, then we're going to respond saying hi. Okay, now let's add our view to our onReady to make it persistent. Okay, now let's add our view to our slash command response. Okay, now let's run our code. Let's go to Discord. Okay, now let's regenerate our button. Let's click hello. It says hi. Let's click it again. It says slow down, try again in 57.5 seconds. If we click it again, it says try again in 52.8 seconds. Okay, so if you found this video helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing. It'll really help out the channel. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to join our Discord or comment down below. Thank you for watching.